Let's start explaining lecture 11 for English students. Lecture 11 in electronics. It talks about the superposition method. Superposition method is a circuit analysis method that is used to get unknown value in the circuit by using a specific procedure such as the mesh analysis and the nodal analysis methods. The procedure of the superposition is that if you would like to get some variable, say the current in a specific branch, and your input resistance, your input circuit consists of different sources, say three sources, the procedure is to activate one of these sources and deactivate the other, and get the current value that we would like to get its value. Then the second step is to activate the second source and deactivate other sources, and get the current value that we intend to get its value, and we refer it as I2. Then we activate the third source and do deactivation to the other sources and get the current value in the branch that we intend to get its value. And refer it to as I3. Then we will do a summation of all these values. These values will be the current values that I intend. Okay. So the procedure of superposition for the contribution, find the contribution due to only one independent source by deactivating all other independent sources. We do this process for all sources. We repeat this process for all sources. Then we sum the individual contribution to obtain the desired voltage or current. Okay, and this procedure and the principle of superposition will be clear after we explain examples. The principle of superposition in any linear circuit containing multiple independent sources. The input circuit must be must contain independent different independent sources to get the current value or the voltage value in a specific point. We have to get this current value for each source acting alone. Okay. This will be explained in detail using this example. In normal cases, if we have this input circuit and would like to get V value, this point, the voltage at this point, using nodal, the question is using nodal analysis get the value of V node. Okay, if I have this input and have this V node value, and use the nodal analysis to solve this example. I will apply the KCL on each node. First of all, I get the reference node. Then I define all the nodes in the circuit, which is this point referred as V. And then we apply the KCL to this point. KCL assumes that the current entering this node and current entering this node in this direction and out of this node in this direction. So, applying the KCL, the input current will be V source minus LV over 2 plus I source equal V minus 0 over 2. Okay, V source as an input equals to the input circuit solve for V node. as a function of v source and the I source will v source equal 10 will I source equal 2. Okay, so in nodal analysis, the input current is v source minus v over 2, which is 10 minus v over 2. Okay. Plus the I source, which is plus the current in this direction, which is I source and have value 2, plus 2 equal V minus 0 over 2, which is V over 2. Okay. After solving this equation, we will have V equal 7. Then V node equal V minus 0. Since it is a volt around the resistor 2 equals V minus L0, which is the reference node, and have value voltage value equals 0, so it will be 7 minus 0, which is 7. Okay, so V node using the nodal analysis will be 0. If you would like to solve this circuit to get V node, using a superposition, the V node value must be equals to 7 at the end. Okay, so we will solve this example of this circuit using a superposition method. Okay. The principle or the procedure of superposition is to get to count the number of sources in your circuit. I have two sources. Okay. So I will make activation of this source and do activation to deactivation to this source. Then in the next step, in the next step, I will make activation to this source and make deactivation to the first source. Okay. For each step of activation, I will get the car as a value of LV node. Again. For a superposition procedure, it asks to get LV node. First step. Our step number A. Is to count the number of sources, which is a number of independent sources, which is two in this example. I have two sources, a voltage source and the current source, okay? The second step, which is step two, step B, is to make activation and deactivation. Activation and deactivation. For each source, okay, and each step and each activation step, I get LV0 or LV node of a source voltage source, and I get LV node of a current source. Then I will make the summation to these values to get the final V node, okay. So the number of sources, the number of independent sources is 2. I1 and I2, or source 1 and source 2. I will get V node, V node 1, by making an activation to by making an activation to source 1. Activate is to leave the source as it is in the circuit and do deactivation to the second source. Okay, so I will have this circuit deactivating the current source will be replaced by open circuit. So this part of the circuit will be removed. I will have only this circuit to get the value of the V node, which is the value which is the volt around the two resistor, 2 kilo resistor, 2 kilo ohm. Using the voltage division, it will be the voltage source multiplied by the value of a resistor, which is 2 over 2 plus 2. Over 2 plus 2. Voltage source value is 10. This resistor value is 2. Then I will make summation to this 2 with the other resistor in series with it, which is also 2. Okay? The value of the V node will be 5. So the V node 1 or V node of the source 1 is 5. The V node 1 is 5. Okay? Second step is to repeat the process for the other source. Is to make activation to this source and make deactivation to the second source or the first source, and deactivation by replacing it with short circuit. Okay, the resulting circuit will be this whole circuit. I would like to get a V node in this circuit. V around any resistor will be current multiplied by R. Okay. The resistor value is 2. Well, current value in the branch of this resistor is equal to 1. Why 1? If its value is 1 multiplied by 2, so V node equal 2 in the second step, V node 2 equal 2. Okay. Why is this current equals to 1? The input current is 2. It will be divided in this branch and this branch. This branch has the same resistor with this branch, so the current will be divided equally. So two will be divided into 1 and 1. Okay, so the current in this branch is 1. I will multiply the current with a resistor to get the V node. Okay, so the V node 2 equals to 2 volt. The final step is to what we did till now. Given the input circuit, make activation to the first source, get the V node for the V source only. Then we'll make activation to this source and get the V zero for the I source only. For I source only mean in the I source is activated and the other is deactivated. For V source only mean in the V source is activated and the other sources are deactivated. Okay, the final V node is equals to V node 1 plus V node 2, which is V node 2, which is 5 plus 2 equals 7. This is the same value that we get using node analysis. So this is the procedure of a superposition. Okay? I hope it became clear somehow for a superposition. The second example in a superposition, this example ask to get the power at resistor 12. Okay. There is an important information about the superposition is that the superposition works only for the current and the volt values. It doesn't work for the power value or even a resistor value, okay? To get the current, unknown value in the circuit which is current, I can use the superposition. To get the unknown value in the circuit which is V, I can use the superposition. If it asks to get the power, I cannot use the superposition or if it asks to about the resistor, okay? What does I mean by I cannot use superposition? I cannot use the superposition with the procedure that I just learned, but I use the superposition with a different way. Okay. So the procedure or the steps that I use to get the current is to count the number of sources, which is source one and source two. And source one is the meter volt. And the second source is 6 ampere. For a mid volt, I get a bar which is some value which is say x1. And for a 6 ampere, I get a bar which is x2. Then I to get a power total or final power, I make a summation for these two values, which is a wrong. Which is a wrong procedure, okay? I will show you the correct procedure if I would like to get a power using a superposition. Okay, to get a power using a superposition, I make I will make an activation to the first source and deactivate the other source, which is replaced by open circuit. This circuit will be this circuit. Okay. For mid volt only, I will get a current in this branch, the current, not the power in this branch. Okay, I will refer it as I1. Okay, I1 will be equals to V over R. V is 100. And the resistor is 6 plus 12. The final value of the I1 will be 5.5. Okay. Then I get the power using the power in this step, which is I square multiplied by R, 12 multiplied by 5.5 square, which will be 370. Okay. To get the power, I make activation. An activation step of all sources. For each source, I get a current value. I can get a current or V, then I get a power, okay? For this circuit, I get a current, I refer it as I1. Refer to it as I1, then I get a power, okay? The second step is to make the activation to the second source. Then for the second source, for a 6 ampere only, I will get a current in this branch. I will refer it as I2. I2 can be get using a voltage division rule, which is L6 is divided to this branch and this branch. The source volt current is 6 multiplied by 1 over 12. Over 1 over 1 over 12 plus 1 over 6. Then the I node is value will be 2. So the power, say the power 2, or the power at this step is equal to I2 square multiplied by R, which will be 48. Okay. The final step is to make a summation of these values, but using this step, not this step. Again, given the input circuit, after activating mid volt only, I get I1 is 5.5, okay? I1 is 5.5. Then for 6 ampere, only, I get the I2, or the current value, second value of the current is 2. I get the power to be 370. The power will be, I will not make a summation of these power values explicitly, the 370 and the 48 to get the final power. But I will make get the power total or final power by making a summation of these step. I1 and I2, I1 and I2 square multiplied by resistor, it will be 675. Okay, this is the correct procedure for getting the power using the superposition. For the third example, it has a circuit with the three voltage sources, three independent sources, and ask to get the V node using superposition. The V node in the circuit is the voltage around the 4 ohm resistor. Our procedure of superposition is to activate the volt 24, this volt, a voltage source, and get LV node, which is V node 1. Then we'll activate the 4 ohm, 4 ohm, 4 ampere source, and get LV node, which is referred as V node 2. Then we get activate the 4 volt source, and get LV node, which is referred as LV node 3. Then we will make summation to all these sources to get the final V node. This is a simple example. It's additional information. It's just we have three sources, not only sources such as other examples. Okay. So for the first source, we activate the 24 volt and get the V node, which is referred as V node 1. After activating, this source, we will have this circuit. Since the current source will replaced by open circuit and the short voltage source was replaced by short circuit, we will have this circuit, equivalent circuit, which has four and two resistors with a 24 volt in series to this. Okay. The V node can be get using a voltage division. The V node is a volt around the resistor 4. It will be 24 multiplied by 4 over 4 plus 2, which is 16. So the V node 1 is 16 volt. Then we do the same process for the 4 volt source. For the four voltage source, we make activation to the source, which means that we it will be in the circuit and do activation to other sources. So the current source will be open circuit and the voltage source will be short circuit. This will be the resulting circuit, equivalent resulting circuit. I will have four series with four voltage and four ohm resistor. V node 2 is a volt around the four resistor. We can apply the KVL in this loop to get the volt at this branch. KVL is to make summation for a voltage. Volt at the two resistor plus the 4 volt plus the volt at the 4 ohm. The volt at two resistor is 2 multiplied by I and plus 4 plus 4 multiplied by I equals 0. Solve to get the I value. The current will be minus 2 over 3. So the volt will be I multiplied by R or R multiplied by I. R multiplied by I. The current value is minus 2. Negative 2 over 3, where resistor is 4, so in the V node will be negative 8 over 3. In V node. Okay. So it will is V node 2 equal negative. Negative 8 over 3. We repeat the same process for the third source. To get LV node 3. So for the 4 ampere source only, we will activate this source and deactivate the other source. By replacing it with short circuit, we will have this circuit. We to get the volt around the V node in this step, it will be the volt the same volt around L4 ohm resistor. والفولت equal الكرنت multiplied by الريزستور. So we would like to get the value of the current in this branch. Okay. The current in this branch can be get using the voltage division. The current source is divided in this branch and this branch. To get the current in this branch, it will be the current source, which is 4. Multiplied by one over four plus 1/2. The resulting value will be 4/3. This negative sign due to the direction of current in this branch or direction of current I. Is in this direction, but the direction of the volt, the V node, is in the negative direction. The V node direction is in this direction, positive from positive to negative. So the current is in the negative direction or the opposite direction of the volt. So we will add the negative. This is the current in this branch. So the final V node is the current multiplied by the resistor. The resistor is 4, where the current is negative 4/3. So the volt will be negative 16/3. The final V node is the summation of all the three voltage value, the V node 1 plus the V node 2 plus LV node 3. Okay. So this is the final V value. Example 4 has an important information about superposition. This circuit has a dependent source. For the case of existing dependent source in the circuit, we didn't do any activation or deactivation to this source. Again, for the superposition procedure, we usually count the number of sources, do activation to the to this source, and do deactivation to the remaining source. But the correct procedure of superposition is to count the number of independent sources only, count the number of independent sources only, and do activation and deactivation to these all sources only, and the dependent source remains the same without any activation or deactivation. So if we count the number of sources in this circuit, it will be only 2. Okay. And our iteration is only 2. So to get I node, I will have I node 1 and I node 2, then I will make a submission for these two values to get the final I node. I will not have I node 3 since this third source is a dependent source. Okay. While activating this source and deactivating the other sources, this source is remains the same. And so on for this source. If I would like to activate the source, fix this source in circuit and remove this source, the dependent source remains the same in the circuit and doesn't change its position for any reason. So to solve this example using superposition, We'll have two circuit. Circuit for the ohm, 4 ohm resistor and circuit for the ال 20 فولت فولت اونلي اوكي فور ذا فور ذا 4 امبير سورس كارنت سورس I will fix this source and remove this voltage source by replacing it with a short circuit. This will be the resulting circuit to get the I-node. The I-node is the current in this branch. If we use the mesh analysis method, I will search for a number of meshes in this circuit. Mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3. Mesh 3. For this answer, I will have an I node equal an I1 minus an I3. Why an I1 minus I3? It will be I1 since an I node is the same direction of an I1. I1 is this direction. Okay, so it will be I1, but it will be I1 minus I3 since an I node is the current in a branch that is common between two. Meshes I mesh 1 and the mesh 3. Okay, so the I node will be I1 minus I3. We will solve the mesh analysis to get the value of I1 and the value of I3. Then the I node equal their subtraction. Okay, it will be I node 1 for the first source. Okay, we have three meshes. The mesh 1 will have an equation, the mesh 2 will have another equation. Well, mesh 3 will have another equation. For mesh 1, we cannot apply KVL directly since we have a current source, I1 equal 4. This is the equation for mesh 1. For mesh 2, starting at this resistor, we have L2I2 minus the 5i node plus the 1 multiplied by the I1 the I2 minus I3 plus the 3 multiplied by the I3 minus I1. Since this is a branch that is common between two meshes, and this is a branch common between two meshes. Okay? I can replace the I node by the I1 minus I3. For the third step, for the third mesh, starting with this resistor, it will be 1 multiplied by I3 minus I2. Okay. Plus 5 I node, plus 4 I3, plus 5 I3 minus I1 equals 0. Okay, we will replace the I node to get, we replace the I node by I1 minus I3 to have three equations with three variables, which are I1 and I2 and I3. Then the I node will be 3.06. Okay. This is for the source 4 ampere. For the 20 volt source. Uh, We will fix this source and remove this source from the circuit since it is an open circuit, replaced by an open circuit. I will have this portion of the circuit with me in this step. And the I node is the current that passes through this branch, this 5 ohm resistor. I can apply el mesh analysis and I will find the two meshes, mesh one and mesh two. As can be noticed, el I node equal minus I2. El I node is the current in this branch and el I2 is the current in this loop. It will be clockwise. El current in this branch is in the negative direction with I node, so I node equal negative I2. Okay. We didn't say that I node equal negative I2 minus I3 or I1 or I2, since this branch is a branch that is not common between two branches. It is a branch in only one mesh. So I will not do any subtraction in this step. Okay. For the 20 volt source, I will apply the KVL to have two equations. Then the I node will be minus I2. Or negative I2. This will refer to this I node as I node 2. Then the final I total will be I node 1, I node 1 plus I node 2. I node 1 is 3.06, well, I node 2 is negative 3.5. So the final I node will be negative 0.46. These two mesh equations, starting with the negative with this resistor, will have two I1 minus I node. Plus 1 I1 minus I2 plus 3 I1 equals 0. We will replace the I2 by negative I, sorry, replace the I node by negative I2. Then the second equation or second mesh equation, starting with this source and the I2 in this direction, so it will be negative 5 I node plus 4 I2 plus minus 20 plus 5 I2 plus 1 I2 minus I1 equals 0. I will replace the I node by negative I2. Then I will solve these two equations with two variables to get I1 and I2. Then the I node will be negative I2. Okay. This all for this lecture. Is three main information that is mentioned in this lecture. The procedure of applying the first information is the procedure of applying the superposition in any circuit. The second information is that in superposition is works only for a volt and a current, and the procedure is changed if we would like to get a bar or any other value. The third information is the existence of dependent source. If the input circuit have dependent source, it remains the same without any activation or deactivation. Okay.